let's take a case study. Brandon, a lot of people know. Earth's Best, where was it 3 years ago and where is it now?
So Earth's Best was our biggest brand when I got here 3 years ago, and it had a 2% EBITDA margin. So it was a huge brand that made no money because it had been overextended. So we proactively exited a whole number of segments. We were in pizza bites and chicken nuggets and diapers and wipes, and we consolidated to the core business. We worked on price size architecture. We worked on renegotiating some of our contracts, and we grew the margins 1,000 basis points over 2 years, which now made it much more worthy of investment. And so now we've started innovating. We've started adding marketing dollars, and the business since March of this year has been up over 20% now that we're investing again. So you've got a very profitable business with very high growth, where before you had a stagnant business with no profitability. So it's a really good kind of poster child of what the strategy was intended to do. And we're now going to extend that to a lot of other brands.
When I look at what I like baby food. I like snacks that don't make me fat. And I like plant-based meat. Now, that had been a category that was kind of one of 500 in the old days. But you've emphasized this thing's going to work. You can do it, but you can blow it out worldwide, right?
Yeah, and so what people don't know is we have a very large brand, Linda McCartney, which is Paul McCartney's family in the UK. That brand's 30 years old. So we've been in plant-based meat there for 30 years. And in Canada, we have the Yves brand, which is also a 30-year-old brand. So we were pioneers in this category, and it's a double-digit growth category. So very well positioned there, and also very well positioned in non-dairy beverages in Europe, which is growing like crazy, and we are very, very well positioned.
Well, I mean, the non-dairy is amazing. I mean, a lot of people, I remember when your predecessor came in, they would have like coconut milk, and then but also would have like some, I don't know, something made of oats, and then there'd be like a yogurt. But in reality, I mean, there is method to the madness as you got it now. Non-dairy is gigantic, and only one company, Oatly, is doing it right. And then you guys come within your company is five Oatlys.
Yeah, so we're actually the number three non-dairy beverage company in Europe. And we're only really penetrated in a meaningful way in Northwestern Europe. So we have plenty of countries to still go into. And we have been growing like crazy. I think our two-year growth rate on non-dairy beverages is close to 20%. So a lot of our international story has been untold over the last couple of years because we were really focused on transforming and resurrecting the North America business. But now as a more global strategy going forward, you're going to see a lot of emphasis on these high-growth categories.
Don't miss a second of Mad Money. Follow at Jim Cramer on Twitter. Have a question? Tweet Cramer, hashtag mad tweets. Send Jim an email to madmoney@cnbc.com or give us a call at 1-800-743-CNBC. Miss something? Head to madmoney.cnbc.com.